Climate change is a reality. No country is immune to its impact. However, developing countries are especially vulnerable since their economies depend mainly on agriculture. Rising global temperatures have been accompanied by changes in existing weather patterns in several countries. Many places are facing changes in rainfall and are suffering from severe heat waves, while others are victims of natural disasters such as drought or floods. In developing countries, the great majority of the population lives on small farms. Small farms of less than 2 hectares are heavily dependent on rain for their cultivation. People's lives and their access to food are strongly affected by a changing climate. Human beings can respond to climate change in 2 ways, through mitigation and through adaptation. For poor people in developing countries, these responses must be combined with development. Humana People to People works every day to improve the living conditions of the most disadvantaged communities. But it is especially through the Farmers Club program that we deal with the direct impact of climate change among poor farmers and communities in developing countries. Farmers Clubs train small-scale farmers in sustainable agricultural practices. They gain the necessary knowledge to adjust their productive cycles to a changing climate and acquire skills in the fields of nutrition, health, and community development. In addition, farmers' clubs organize smallholder producers so that they can take advantage of all the available resources in a sustainable way. Only by doing this will we be able to produce enough food for everybody in the long term. Soil quality is at risk, not only due to climate change, but also due to other human activities. Through farmers' clubs, the members learn to use conservation farming practices. These consist of making and using compost to improve the fertility of the soil. In some areas, farmers' clubs are also planting trees in their crop fields. This helps keep moisture in the ground and protects crops from wilting and suffering from water loss. Trees also contribute to adding important nutrients to the soil.
We are planting trees in the different areas around this Mikolongo Vocational School. So we have planted almost 150,000 starting from last year up to this year. We are continuing planting those trees. In this area, we have 2 mountains which we have planted trees, and now, as you can see, this mountain is bare. We need to make this area to be covered with the trees. And as we have also seen, the communities, they are working hand in hand with the school, vocational school, together with the students to work together so that they should maintain our natural climate, so that people should have a better place to live.
With climate change, amounts and the availability of water have become unpredictable. Some areas will have less water than before, others will have much more, but most will be affected by not knowing when it will come. Water management therefore becomes a critical issue for communities living from their farming. Water management includes irrigation systems which are simple and save water.
Here in Mozambique, Cabo Delgado, we are suffering because the climate change, because the water is not easy. It's very difficult to have water. Then the members, they need to have the vegetable production, but they don't know how. That's why we're training people, we teach them how they can get a lot of water so that they can have productive vegetables in their fields.
Farmers' clubs promote sustainable water management through the construction of small dams, weirs, and reservoirs to harvest rainwater. Rope and washer pumps, protected wells and water filters guarantee the families access to fresh and clean water. One important aspect of an improved life for rural communities is the access to energy. Most rural people live with firewood as the principal source of energy for cooking and even use it for heating. Sometimes kerosene and gas oil are used to run lanterns and small generators.
In energy solar project, we provide the light for the people where we have 40 stations. Each station have 60 lamps where the people come in the station. They can pay something to have one lamp. They can use the lamp for 2 days. Now the children, they can study in the night. Also, we can have literacy in the night.
Solar charging stations, solar panels in community houses, solar water pumps in gardens, and solar dryers have been established in some of the clubs. One of the main projects has focused on the distribution of solar-powered lanterns to help the communities light their lives in a sustainable way. Several farmers' clubs have introduced the use of other energy sources, such as biogas or biofuel generated through jatropha seed oil. These fuels are less harmful to their health, reduce pollution, and at the same time, the production residues offer a natural fertilizer for the soil.
The biogas system, we just have it, it's like a pilot project. And then we just have it in Bilibiza, where we have one in the training college for the students. We have one in the clinic for the community.
Em parceria com o Centro de Saúde e a DPP, fomos oferecido, né? Teve apoio de biodigestor, que esse biodigestor nos ajudou na parte da cozinha e esterilização. E nesse momento já pronto, não gastamos mais gás, né, para comprar, para esterilizar o material. Usamos esse gás de biodigestor e para a cozinha também já não sacrificamos de comprar lenha para a cozinha. Usamos um pouco de biodigestor para a cozinha.
When rural and urban dwellers in developing countries cook on an open fire, which is in the majority of cases, firewood or charcoal have been chopped from forests in the neighborhood or more distant fields. 5% of world deforestation is caused by firewood charcoal demand. With improved firewood, saving stoves, the need for firewood is reduced by up to 50%. In this way, the pressure on woodland is also reduced, and as a result of cleaner burning, there is less smoke and fewer chances of respiratory diseases. At all levels of society, the understanding of climate change, of how to mitigate it, and how to adapt to it, is essential to take inclusive and solidary action. In all of our projects and activities, be they in the global south or in the north, this major challenge to humanity is addressed with explanation, understanding, and a will to seek the common and concerted action that it takes to face it.
Over the last years now, I've been starting up new programs, especially in connection with our vocational school, where we have started up courses in what we call renewable energy. We are teaching the youth there both how to maintain solar panels and even go in for bio fuel, or even how to hopefully also use wind energy one day in Malawi.
These are our students who are undergoing a one-year training in renewable energy, that is level one. So here they will learn about how to build a solar cooker. So if they build it and use it for boiling water, we'll save some firewood. And we only use firewood when it is cloudy or a windy day where there is no presence of sunlight. And also they learn about how to connect solar PV components like solar panels, solar regulator that protects battery from being overcharged and also from being over discharged.
In our own very close environment, the management of used clothing allows Humana to raise funds to finance development cooperation products in the South. Reusing clothes saves resources for the production of new clothes, minimizes the emission of greenhouse gases, and spares millions of tons of clothes from going into landfills. A single Humana container saves more than 10 tons of carbon dioxide from being released into the atmosphere every year. Besides that, it decreases the environmental impact of agrochemicals involved in the production of cotton and other fibers. At Humana, we believe in acknowledging the challenges and in finding ways of dealing with them by forming a true alliance among people living all around the globe. We share this globe of ours, and its climate is a fundamental condition for life.